Spiramycin is a macrolide antimicrobial agent used in the treatment of various bacterial infections. In this video, let's find found. What is spiramycin? What is spiramycin used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking spiramycin? Spiramycin work. How to use spiramycin? What is spiramycin? Spiramycin is a macrolide antibiotic and antiparasitic. It is used to treat toxoplasmosis and various other infections of soft tissues. Spiramycin has been used in Europe since the year 2000 under the trade name Rovamycine, produced by Rhône-Poulenc Rohrer. Sanofi and Famer-Lyon, France, and Exacibasi Ilac, Turkey. It also goes under the name Rovamycine in Canada, distributed by Odin Laboratories, where it is mostly marketed to dentists for mouth infections. What is spiramycin used for? Macrolide antibiotic for treatment of various infections. Contraindication. Spiramycin is contraindicated in cases of known hypersensitivity to spiramycin or to other antibiotics of the macrolide group, or to any of the excipients. Note when using spiramycin, because spiramycin can be toxic to the liver. So it should be used with caution people with liver dysfunction. Side effects. Common side effects of spiramycin include stomach pain, nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. Most of these side effects of spiramycin do not require medical attention and gradually resolve over time. However, if the side effects persist or worsen, please consult your doctor. Pharmacodynamic. The absolute bioavailability of oral spiramycin is generally within the range of 30-40%. After a 1 g oral dose, the maximum serum drug concentration was found to be within the range 0.4-1.4 mg/L. Mechanism of action. The mechanism of action of macrolides has been a matter of controversy for some time. Spiramycin, a 16-membered macrolide, inhibits translocation by binding to bacterial 50S ribosomal subunits with an apparent 1:1 stoichiometry. This antibiotic is a potent inhibitor of the binding to the ribosome of both donor and acceptor substrates. The primary mechanism of action is done by stimulation of dissociation of peptidyl tRNA from ribosomes during translocation. Half-life. Intravenous, young persons, 18 to 32 years of age, approximately 4.5 to 6.2 hours. Elderly persons, 73 to 85 years of age, approximately 9.8 to 13.5 hours. Oral, 5.5 to 8 hours, rectal in children, 8 hours. Dose. The dose of this medicine will be different for different patients. For oral dosage forms, capsules or tablets. For treatment of infections. Adults and teenagers, 1 to 2 grams, 3 million to 6 million international units, IU, 2 times a day. Or 500 milligrams to 1 gram, 1,500,000 to 3 million IU, 3 times a day. For severe infections, the dose is 2 to 2.5 grams, 6 million to 7,500,000 IU. 2 times a day. Children weighing 20 kilograms, kg, 44 pounds, or more, dose is based on body weight. The usual dose is 25 milligrams, 75,000 IU, per kg, 11.4 milligrams per pound, of body weight 2 times a day, or 17 milligrams, 51,000 IU, per kg, 7.7 grams per pound, of body weight 3 times a day. For injection dosage form. For treatment of infections. Adults and teenagers, 500 mg, 1,500,000 IU, injected slowly into a vein every 8 hours. For severe infections, that is 1 gram, 3 million IU, injected slowly into a vein every 8 hours. Children, use and dose must be determined by your doctor. For rectal dosage form, suppository. For treatment of infections. Adults and children 12 years of age and over, 2,750 mg, 1,950,000 IU, suppositories per day. Children up to 12 years of age, 2 or 3 500 mg, 1,300,000 IU, suppositories per day. Newborns, doses based on body weight. The usual dose 1,250 mg, 650,000 IU, suppository per 5 kg, 250 mg suppository per 11 pounds, of body weight once a day. Safety advice. Spiramycin is a pregnancy category C drug. If you are pregnant, think you may be pregnant, or planning pregnancy, consult your doctor before taking spiramycin. Your doctor may prescribe this medicine only if the benefits outweigh the risks. That's all the information about spiramycin we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.